Hey guys, so today I want to talk to you about man-in-the-middle attacks, what they are, how you can protect yourself. I'm also going to demonstrate a man-in-the-middle attack so you can see how you can use it to also do a checkup on your own privacy. A man-in-the-middle attack is where a hacker or other individual sits in the middle of a connection. Now, this can be done a multitude of ways, whether it's through the internet, it would be through ARP protocol, which the ARP protocol, a hacker would be able to pretend they are you and basically act as a proxy in between you as a computer or phone user and the website you want to view. What the attacker does is sends ARP replies. The hacker at least becomes a proxy, and all packets will then be going through that attacker, and it will appear as if you are connected to the website or service that you were trying to use, but really the attacker is getting it along the way and is acting as you, or is acting as your router, depending on how they perform the attack. This is done also, can be done with the IMS eyecatchers, or stingrays as they are known. You can see my other video more in depth on how stingrays work. The attacker would be a fake cell tower in between your cell phone and the real cell tower by faking a stronger signal. You may notice signal going up. You may notice battery drain in this type of attack. This is a cellular man-in-the-middle attack. Now, what can we do to protect ourselves? Well, we can use Tor, and Tor is a way you can protect yourself with a man-in-the-middle attack. I'm putting together different privacy Tor routers, so if anyone's interested in that, you can email me and help support the channel that way. There are other, as I mentioned, the internet, ARP poisoning, and ARP spoofing sends all the traffic to the attacker in between. That is where the man in the middle part comes from. And this is essentially a simplified version of what is happening. You have the victim here, either a phone or PC. You have the man in the middle, the attacker doing the man in the middle, is then getting all of it and sniffing all of the traffic. So I've set up a man-in-the-middle attack here so we can take a look. I have a cell phone, and we're seeing all the different packets that are going between the router and that cell phone. This can also help you check up on if your cell phone has, say, a backdoor or is sending some of your private data to parties it should not be sending to. We can take a look at some of these addresses, and we can then do research on some of those addresses to find out who the cell phone is contacting. We can see Instagram, Facebook. We can see and we can gather a lot of information. If we were the attacker, we can then also send false SSL certificates. So if you look at the top of your screen, we see the green padlock here. If there's a man in the middle attack, there may be a break in this padlock on the victim's screen. That's another way to identify certain man in the middle attacks. Not always though. For example, if you have a root certificate that the attacker has control of, in that case, you will look like you are securely connected to this website. A false sense of security by viewing what they believe they were viewing. And as you can see, we're reading what they are reading. And if the attacker was performing this man-in-the-middle attack, they would be able to read everything that is going over the line. So this can be during the IMS eyecatcher. This could be during a man-in-the-middle attack on the network. A man-in-the-middle attack can be performed by anyone who has access to that network. So if you give out your Wi-Fi password to friends or guests, keep in mind they could perform a man-in-the-middle attack on you. Keep in mind your Internet of Things devices can perform man-in-the-middle attacks on you. This is something that most people don't realize, that when you share your internet access, you allow someone to connect to your network. They're able to see all the computers and devices that are connected to your Wi-Fi. They're also allowed to then send ARP poisoning and spoofing in order to perform that man-in-the-middle attack, and they can then spy on you. Or they could leave a backdoor that sends all of this data over to a third party logging system that would log all this data, and they would have very little risk doing something like that. So man-in-the-middle attacks are very, very dangerous. They're one of the biggest dangers on your network and on your cell phone. So as I mentioned, cell phones are really not good for privacy. Now you'll see me covering the PinePhone a lot, and there's a lot of benefits to the PinePhone. I'm going to do a video specific to that. For example, on the PinePhone has the LTE modem, which is a closed source piece of hardware. It actually runs a black box system. So the LTE modem, the good thing about the PinePhone, unlike Android and iPhone, which puts their LTE modem on the same placement as the rest of their, you know, CPU, the PinePhone, on the other hand, has a USB connection that is only allowed to access that LTE modem as long as your operating system of choice is asking to access it. So it is a permission-based system using USB as the bridge. So this is what a man-in-the-middle attack would look like. An attacker could then gather as much information on you as possible. Now you can use a man-in-the-middle attack to your advantage. Now for legal purposes, in order to check your own phone, you can use a man-in-the-middle attack to check your own devices. If you perform a man-in-the-middle attack on your device, you are able to see what it's doing behind the scenes. And for that, you'll be able to gather information on yourself and see if you maybe have a Trojan horse on your phone or maybe a Trojan horse on your computer. So, as I mentioned, you can use Tor as a method to protect yourself against a man-in-the-middle attack, as Tor traffic is encrypted from your device to the network, and then from the exit node, it then, as long as you're using a encrypted website, it stays secure that way. Now, if you don't, the exit node is a point of weakness if you're not using an encrypted website, an HTTPS, or an onion domain. So this is what a man-in-the-middle attack looks like. I hope you've learned something, and I'm going to go over more on man-in-the-middle attack. We can also reverse lookup these IP addresses to find out who exactly we're contacting. We can use geolocation to then find out where that server's located, find out more about who it is contacting. We can gather more information on that. So this video is about protecting yourself, and using man-in-the-middle attacks can be used to investigate your own devices, find out if your phone or computer is connecting to something it shouldn't be. So that is what a man-in-the-middle attack is. As you can see, the display on the ARP spoofing man-in-the-middle attacks. I mentioned the man-in-the-middle attack on IMSI catchers. That can also be protected using Tor. If you use something like Orbot, you can protect yourself because all of your stuff will go through the Tor network. Or if you use one of the Tor routers, if you set one up yourself, you could set up a Tor router. That is the recommended way to use Tor according to the Tor project, because with software alone, that is a point of weakness. If something happens in the software, it could leak your real IP or your MAC address. Now, if you're using a properly set up Tor router, that can further protect you from these kinds of things. As I mentioned, I'm setting up these Tor privacy routers with some of my own stuff for additional privacy. So if you're interested in that, just send me an email and help support the channel at righttoprivacy@tutanota.com. So hope you guys learned something about man-in-the-middle attacks, how you can use them to your advantage, and how you can also use those to find out what your phone is doing behind the scenes. That's what I got today, guys. I hope you liked the video. So please like, share, and subscribe, and thanks for watching.